I'm about to derez in my pants.
Hey, this is John Carlos, and I went to Corner Store Comics and got the Tron Legacy Light Cycle from Hot Toys. This thing was announced in November of 2010, and it finally came out in August of 2012. Was that worth the wait? I don't know. Let's find out.
Here we've got the Sam Flynn figure, separate helmeted head, attachable arms, batteries, joints, third leg, two identity discs. One goes on the back to hold the figure into place on the bike. The other is for display with this alternate hand.
Based on the photographs, I wasn't so sure about the likeness of this figure, but once you get it in person, it's a really good likeness. And you can also note that the light source comes through the ball joints. And the lighting for this helmet comes with two little batteries, which thankfully are included.
I already know that I'm going to want to display this with the identity disc hand, so let's not waste any time with that. Activate the battery. Switch. The softness of this plastic helmet and like the hardness, it's really hard to put this helmet on without feeling like you're going to break the helmet. Alrighty.
Ooh. Ah.
Check out the detail on the inside of that panel.
Hey! If you're thinking about getting this, here's some things you might want to know. The Sideshow website lists that this comes with one identity disk, when in fact it comes with two, and it lists that it's not removable. However, it is removable. You just shouldn't remove it because you need it to hold the figure into place. Also, the Sideshow website says that the light cycle itself requires three A batteries, but the instruction manual that it comes with says it requires three AAA batteries, and then when you open up the battery compartment, it's in fact three AA batteries that you need. In advance, I was kind of worried about the lighting on this, based on what I'd seen online. But once I got it and opened it up, I'm really happy with how it turned out. There are little points all over the body where there are LEDs built in, and that light is supposed to travel through an entire space. Technically, maybe on the arm, it's stronger at the shoulder than it is at the wrist, and that doesn't bother me whatsoever. It's a miracle that this thing even lights up as much as it does. I think it's great. Although Hot Toys typically makes 1/6 scale figures with true type bodies, I'm not upset that this is not a true type figure. I think that if they made a true type figure, then it wouldn't light up properly. It's got too many joints. So if you're going to make a figure that can light up, might as well be posed with a light cycle. It makes sense to me. It's a great sculpt. I love it. My only complaint? It makes me want more Hot Toys Tron Legacy figures. I mean, if they can make a Harry Osborn from Spider-Man 3, then they could totally make a Korra or a Rensler. Or at the very least, make them limited and sell them at their toy fairs next summer as an exclusive. I mean, a Gem exclusive would be way better than an Angelica from Pirates 4 exclusive.